this video, I'll help you with how to write an IT security policy. By the end of this video, you'll know what exactly an IT security policy is, why you should have one, how to write it, and how it can help you create a stronger IT security culture in your organization. This guide is based on our free IT security policy template, which you can download and follow along with as you watch this video. You can use this template for your organization to strengthen your IT security culture. So let's get right into it. The purpose of an IT security policy is to provide a general framework for your organization. It's quite a small document with only a couple of pages, but these couple of pages are highly valuable. They include the objectives and ambitions for your IT security. The policy also helps to delegate responsibility for IT security in your organization. Before we talk about how to write an IT security policy, let's talk about why it's important to have one. Having an information security policy in place is important for several reasons. First, it sets expectations for the handling of sensitive data and lays out guidelines for how it should be managed. Second, it can help to protect an organization from cyber attacks, malicious behavior, or data loss due to a lack of security protocols. Third, an information security policy gives employees clear instructions on their responsibilities when dealing with sensitive data, helping to reduce potential security risks. Finally, having a comprehensive IT security policy can help to prevent or mitigate costly regulatory fines if an organization is found to be in breach of data protection laws. So now that we've covered what an IT security policy does and why it's a good idea to have one in your organization, let's do a deep dive and we'll walk through how you can write your own. In this video, we'll go through our template and the 7 different steps that you need to consider. These are the purpose of the IT security policy, validity, objectives, organization and responsibilities, waiver, reporting, and violation. The first thing you need to consider is the purpose of your IT security policy. Step 1, the purpose of the IT security policy. Typically, the purpose of the policy is to set the framework for the management of IT security in the organization. In our template, we write, "The security policy defines the framework for the management of information security in organization X." Ultimately, this point dictates the framework of IT security in your organization. Step 2, validity. The next step in your information security policy is to determine who the policy affects. Typically, this could be all employees in your organization, but you could also include freelancers or consultants who work for you. It could, for example, be, "The security policy applies to all employees in the organization and the entire access to X's information systems." This is an important part of the IT security policy, as this is where you decide who it affects. Are there any employees that should be exempt from the policy? Should you have another policy for freelancers? This is for you to decide. Step 3, objectives. This is where you outline the objectives of your IT security policy. It's a central element of the policy and where you define what you want to achieve. The objectives should fit your organization. So every IT security policy might not have the same objectives, but they all have the same goal, stronger IT security. You're in line with the IT security policy if you comply with the objectives. In our template, we have 8 examples of objectives. The objective of your IT security policy could be a risk-based approach. In this case, you might say, "Org X uses a risk-based approach where the level of protection and its cost must be based on the business risk and impact assessment that must be carried out annually as a minimum." If you're interested in knowing more about using a risk-based approach, we've written a blog post about it, which you can see here. It also includes a free template. Another objective could be, "X aims to comply with relevant legislation, including the GDPR, for example." It's important to note that your IT security policy can have multiple objectives. As your organization changes, it's a good idea to regularly review your IT security policy so you can make sure you're keeping it up to date. Step 4, organization and responsibilities. When creating an IT security policy, it's important to establish who is responsible for the security of your organization and its data. The responsibilities should be delegated across your organization, and the policy is an effective tool for doing this. This includes clearly designating roles in your organization. For example, identify a person within your organization who will be accountable for compliance with the policy. This could, for example, be your data protection officer, if you have one in your organization. You should also clearly define the roles and responsibilities of other employees in your organization so that you can ensure compliance with the policy. Examples of delegation of responsibility, as shown in our IT security policy template, could be something like, the IT department consults, coordinates, controls, and reports on the status of the security. The IT department prepares guidelines and procedures. And the individual employee is responsible for complying with the IT security policy and being informed about the IT usage policy. Remember, your IT security policy should mirror your organization's reality. The IT department might not have ownership of every information system in your organization. Step 5, waiver. This is a short but important step. Waivers are exceptions where responsibilities and objectives are not applicable. If you don't have any clear exceptions, you can formulate a statement such as, waivers for X's information security policy and guidelines are approved by the IT department based on the guidelines laid out by the executive board. Step 6, reporting. Establishing a clear reporting process for security issues is key to ensuring the safety of your organization's data. By having a proper reporting process in place, you create a positive feedback loop in your IT security work. In this step, you highlight the areas of responsibility, ensure progress toward objectives, and guarantee that everyone knows their responsibilities. Examples of the reporting process could be, the IT department informs the executive board about all relevant security breaches. The status of waivers is included in the IT department's annual report to the executive board. Or, the executive board reviews the security status annually and reports to the board of directors afterward. Step 7, violation. This part deals with what happens when someone intentionally violates the IT security policy. Here, you must decide whose responsibility it is to deal with violations like these. It could be the HR department, the person responsible for the IT department, or the CEO. No matter who it is, you need to make sure you know who should act on it. In our template, we've written, intentional violation and abuse are reported by the IT department to the HR department and the closest authority with lead responsibility. Violation of the information security policy and supporting guidelines may result in employment law consequences. Of course, remember to fit the template to your organization's needs. If you don't have an IT or an HR department, just go ahead and designate someone else. And that's it. Now I'll give you some tips for how to make sure that everyone in your organization follows the IT security policy. Ensure that everyone understands the policy. All employees should read and understand the IT security policy. Conduct regular reviews and audits. Regularly review the effectiveness of your security measures and document any changes. Regular training sessions can help to ensure that everyone understands the key concepts and requirements, as well as any changes to the policy. Develop a culture of security. Talk openly about security issues and make sure that all employees feel comfortable to report or bring up any potential security threats. When writing an information security policy, some common mistakes include failing to define clear roles and responsibilities, not explaining the processes for reporting and responding to risks, or forgetting to regularly update the policy. To avoid these pitfalls, make sure to assign appropriate roles and responsibilities. Explain in detail the process for reporting and responding to security incidents, and keep the policy up to date as new threats emerge. We recommend reviewing and updating the policy at least once a year. The IT security policy creates objectives for your organization that you can then follow up on by creating more concrete guidelines and rules for your employees to follow. These guidelines and rules are usually written in an acceptable use policy. If you'd like to know more about writing an acceptable use policy, we have a blog post on it that you can read by clicking here. Together, by having both an IT security policy and an acceptable use policy, you create the foundation for a strong IT security culture in your organization. So that's it. Thanks for following along with me. I hope you learned something about how to write an IT security policy. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to us. Our email address is info@cyberpilot.io. Thanks again. Bye.